He's back in the news, Ken Bone, Mr. Stein. What can you tell us about it?
Yeah, the Bone Zone. Remember this?
Yes.
4 years ago, almost to the day, October 2016, Ken Bone showed up at one of these debates between Hillary and Donald Trump. And he was where he's overweight, chubby guy. He had that red sweater on, that pencil mustache, and that bald head. And
no one for me?
Everybody. He became an instant celebrity when he asked. It wasn't even the question so much as the way he looked, but he did. Here he is in 2016, Sean, asking the question.
Yeah. What steps will your energy policy take to meet our energy needs while at the same time remaining environmentally friendly and minimizing job loss for fossil power plant workers?
Boring.
Very boring.
So anyway, he wasn't famous for the question. He was famous for his look.
His shirt.
The Bone Zone. That's what
I like to make love.
Shortly after that debate performance, he put on his Instagram, buy a one-way ticket to the hashtag Bone Zone, join the movement. And he had T-shirts with his image on it.
That man does not look like he should be around anybody under the age of 16.
I'll just be your secret lover.
he was kind of that year's Joe the Plumber, you know, kind of an average dude who became super famous and got his 15 minutes of fame.
Right.
Well, anyway, you know, so after he became famous back in 2016, the media went to work, and it didn't take much. They just went to his Reddit account.
Oh, boy.
And they found all kinds of stuff about him.
Oh, boy. What did they find?
Kind of confirmed the catch-a-predator image. Bone's questionable Reddit posts included a number of comments about the bodies of women in not-safe-for-work photos, as well as a confession that he once committed felony insurance fraud, forging documents that make it appear he had a car insurance for his pizza delivery gig.
Wait, he bragged about it on social media?
Yeah, apparently.
What a dope.
In addition, he wrote candid...
Keep that stuff private, man.
In addition, he wrote candid comments about the killing of Trayvon Martin, which he referred to as justified. He also acquitted gunman George Zimmerman a big old S-bird. And then in another post, he referenced...
I want to wrestle you so freaking bad.
In another post, he referenced Jennifer Lawrence hack-nude photos from 2014. Remember that? Maybe she should have been more careful with her pics, but the bad guys are the ones who sought them out and looked at them, which, by the way, includes me. I saw her blank hole, and I liked it.
I just love these drops from To Catch a Predator.
Yeah, I know.
I'm dying here. All right, so...
So
the real question that he should have asked at the debate was, do you think it's wrong if I brag about robbing a bank? Can I get arrested for it? How stupid are you to brag about crimes that you've committed, not just to your friends, but on social media and publicly so everybody can see it? How stupid are you? Hey, do you remember that time I went out with a 15-year-old girl? At the time, I was 45 years old. It was awesome. Yeah, I mean, that would be good.
So anyway, the reason we bring this up is that Ken Bone, hashtag Ken Bone, was trending this morning on Twitter. And the reason is that he spoke to Newsweek magazine, and he weighed in on his thoughts on the last debate between President Trump and Joe Biden. So he had these thoughts. I think we have some audio of that here.
It was insanity. I didn't have a very high opinion of either of them to begin with, so it was hard to lower it. I think Joe Biden did a much better job than Donald Trump, but he wasn't exactly John F. Kennedy up there. What we saw on Tuesday night was precisely an example of everything that's wrong with politics. It was both candidates trying to get a 5-second soundbite that could get repeated over and over again. It was paring everything down to one sentence and ignoring context and nuance.
Okay, what's up with the porn music in the background?
Newsweek posted that video. It's the only place I could find it.
He's like, I don't know, he looks like Ron Jeremy's out of shape brother. Not to say that Ron Jeremy's in good shape.
So anyway, Mr. Bone.
Can we call him Mr. Bone?
He claims that he is once again an undecided voter.
He's an idiot.
If you believe that.
He's a complete idiot.
But anyway, now he's, I mean, people are seeking out his
wisdom. If you're an undecided, okay, can I just be honest here real quickly? If you, right now at this point, if you're an undecided voter, you're not very bright. How have you not made your decision by now? Maybe you're a guy like a Ken Bone who likes to wear red sweaters and holds candy in his pocket to try to
I'll make it feel really good for you, huh?
I mean, Biden has been all over the place on policy. And if you're voting based on, I mean, if you're not just voting because you hate Donald Trump so much that you want him out of office, it's at this point it's really hard to get excited about Joe Biden because he's
not excited about Joe Biden.
But there's a lot of people right now that are just not sure where Joe Biden is at on policy. Like, for example, if he decides to stack the Supreme Court with five or four more justices, that'll have serious long-term consequences, as will the filibuster.
Okay, so you're talking about some policies, but my opinion, people
make their decision. You're calling people stupid.
Yes.
You're calling people idiots.
Yes.
For not being fully informed on policy and not being able to make their decision because they don't have the information.
It goes both ways, where there's people who don't know about where Trump stands and there's people who don't know where Biden stands.
If you're that confused about policy,
there's more than Trump stands.
If you're that confused about where Joe Biden or Donald Trump, for that matter, stands on policy, all you have to do is have a computer in front of you, like Mr. Bone does.
And I'm big.
Yeah, and I wouldn't want to be on Bone's laptop, by the way. I don't know what's on there. And look up the policies of both Donald Trump and Joe Biden. All I'm simply saying is this: if you still don't have at least an inkling or where you're going or decision on who you're going to be voting for, there's something really wrong with you. We have had a long time now with Joe Biden on the stage, with Trump being president for almost 4 years. If you are still one of those people that are undecided like Mr. Bone, then you are a bone yourself. You're a bonehead.
Most girls can't
handle it. Speaking of undecided voters, the town hall that Joe Biden did 2 nights ago, the claim that everyone there was undecided. Well, one of those guys was definitely not undecided. In fact, he was featured on MSNBC 2 weeks earlier.
Okay.